Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani. Is one vial of filler really all you need? Okay, so you're seeing it over the internet, you're seeing YouTube videos and people talking about, oh, you only need one vial of filler and look what I can do with one vial of filler. The new products are amazing. So I thought I'd address it and give you my take on it. And certainly everyone has their opinion on fillers and they use them different ways. Everyone has different practices as well. So understand, some practices are seeing an older demographic, some are seeing a younger demographic, some see all types. Some are device oriented. So they are doing a lot of lasers and laser resurfacing and radio frequency and facelift by devices, which really it isn't possible, but it is good marketing and people make a lot of money on devices. And as you know from the videos here, we do a lot of combination therapies and certainly everyone has their own genre and style of practice and that's great. It's the way it should be. I wanted to talk about the one vial of filler and what the concepts are about it. A lot of people have asked, why would I be told to get three vials of filler or four or five or combination therapies if other people are saying one vial of filler is all you need to make a difference in a face? Let's talk about three factors to consider for that one vial of filler and what you can actually get out of it. So the first thing to answer is, what is a vial of filler? And to answer that first, we need to know what filler we're talking about. When we talk about fillers, we're talking about collagen stimulators, we're talking about hyaluronic acid fillers, PMMA, which is polymethyl methacrylic acid fillers, such as Belafil in this country, Sculptor is PLLA, water is its carrier, and of course hyaluronic acids are mainly gels. And then you have other fillers in other countries, or quote unquote fillers. So it really depends on one vial of what. And vials come in different sizes. And some people say, well, 1 mL of filler, something like Radius, just for educational purposes, often comes in a 0.8 or most commonly 1.5 mLs, meaning you're getting more filler. The reality is, and Radius is a great filler, a lot of that is carboxymethylcellulose or a carrier, but it's a different animal in that calcium does some collagen stimulating and hangs out around a lot longer. So it's hard to compare all of those, but for practical purposes, most people are going to refer to HA or let's say hyaluronic acid filler. So when we say what is a vial of filler, first of all, which one? So let's, for the purpose of this, say one vial of filler. And the argument that people make is two things would be the mainstay of the argument. Number one is myomodulation. So we know the face has movement. And the idea is if we strategically place this filler, that we can change the movement of the face and lift the corner of the mouth, create a lifting effect. And often they'll lift the tissue and put boluses down along the periosteum and along the bone to create that lifting effect. And so myomodulation would be one, and the other would be paying attention to the ligamentous structures in the face. We have many, but say the orbicularis oculi retaining ligament, zygomatic cutaneous retaining ligament. And if you know your anatomy perfectly, that you can manipulate these in some way to create that. And by adding one vial of filler, half and half, some people do one and one, they can show and demonstrate that the face lifts. Indeed, this is the case. If you lift and you put a bolus, you can see a lifting at the edge of the mouth. The problem is, one, a lot of the people that demonstrate on don't have a lot of facial fat, and two, let's see what they look like not only in 2 days to 7 days, but in 1 month. It doesn't maintain that lift long term. So myomodulation and the ligamentous structures are thought to play a role. So 1 mL of filler, and let's look, I'll show you a demonstration here. You can see here, this is one vial of filler being poured out, just to give you an idea of what it is and the amount it is. If it's hard to tell from that, one thing you can do is think of a teaspoon. We all know what a teaspoon is and what it looks like, especially if people are cooking and they know they have a measurement of a teaspoon, and that's 5 mLs. 1 teaspoon is 5 vials of filler, or hyaluronic acid filler, just to give you an idea of what it actually is. So the first point, what is a vial of filler? We're saying for this purpose, it's 1 mL of a hyaluronic acid. And the second, the type of filler, understand the collagen stimulators and the gel fillers. We're gonna go with the gel filler. Now, what you need to know is the third point. And that is anatomy of what we're doing, where the filler's going. So I'll give you a few examples. Number one, let's take that 1 mL and let's say temporal hollowing. So the temple, not to go into the detail of the anatomy here, but the temple, if people are doing fat transfer and fat is cheap because you're taking it out of your own body and you process it, they might put 10, 20, 30 cc's in a temple. That will be 30 vials of filler. You don't have to exchange one for one, but the idea is, imagine one filler in a temple. You might see it initially because there's some swelling. You're not going to see anything. If you look at that in a month or two, it will be gone. And partially because you have the temporalis muscle, one of the deepest layer, is a movement muscle. You eat, you chew, you talk. Some talk more than others. And it burns it off. That's why lip filler goes away first. We talk, we move. One of the reasons it goes away quickly is because movement wears off filler. So think about what one vial would do here. So where it's placed, what part of the anatomy. One of the things we know from the studies of fillers, a FDA approved cheek filler, if you're on the bone, 1 to 2 vials per side, so 3 to 4 vials, will make a really nice difference. But the minute we go to the submalar area, there's no bone, you can feel that here, there's parotid gland, and then if you move anterior, it's really the mouth that's next, nothing supporting that. And because of that, as you add filler down below here, you can add multiple vials, and 7 to 9 vials were used in some of the studies. So 9 vials would be $9,000, average price around the country, and more. If you go to the East Coast, New York, or some places, vials are around $1,800 a vial in some places. So that breaks the bank, which is why certain anatomical areas I like permanent products can work well, or biostimulators like some people use Radius, PLLA or Sculptor is great. Plus, the less you have to be injected in not only dangerous areas, but also the less you have to be injected, the safer it is for you, the better it is, the more cost effective. So when you take a 2 to 5 year product or even a permanent product, if it's in the right place in the safe area, then that saves you a lot of time, money, and danger. Danger, the more you have to be injected, there's a danger factor with there. Permanent products also have a danger factor, but if done in the right place, they make sense. Anatomically, think of something else. Take a thin face that has some facial fat below in the submalar area, but has nothing up top. If you add that product on the bone, then you're going to get a nice result, as we mentioned. Now take that same face and imagine it has fat. So it's a larger face that has fat. Now fat can be youthful, so it's not a bad thing, but the filler will be hidden in there. So when someone comes in with a larger face or adipose tissue, I know they're likely gonna need more filler. And of course, what do people want from filler? That's the third question. Are we creating angles and folds? A cheek on the zygomatic bone, a lip, sure, that's one filler. You can get a sustained difference. You're not going to lift the edge of the mouth long term, but you will get a nice result with one vial in the lip, one vial in each cheek, and that can sustain and last. But that's not what creates youth. So if you're creating angles and folds for a young person, yes, low volume is great. When someone comes in over the age of 40, 50, 60, and they want to rejuvenate, one vial of filler, it's as much as a waste of time, because the eye is drooping from bone loss. We want to lift the edge of the eye, collagen stimulators in the temple. They may have high cheekbones. That's what keeps the beautiful people who are older looking beautiful, good structural support in the bone. They might not need filler here, but they may. Then take the preauricular area. If someone's in shape and there's volume loss here, it's a great opportunity to pull the face back and lift the corner of the mouth. But that opportunity can't be realized if we're only using gel fillers, because they'll get lost in here. So one vial of filler there is definitely a waste of time. You need a collagen stimulator, a long-term filler, or combination, or PDO thread to lift and then volumize, better yet. So that gives you some ideas of factors that go through your injector's mind that you should consider before thinking that you want one vial of filler to make facial rejuvenation. If you want a lip filler, an angle, a fold, a rejuvenating look, it can work well for you if you're willing to build up over time. If you're using combination treatments, I might do full plasma sculpt, but then add a couple vials of filler and not use much HA filler, because remember, it can draw water in, it can give a fake look. It's best at contouring and creating angles and folds. So it depends what you're looking for the product to do, but to think that one vial of filler a year, or coming into your med spa or your doctor and getting one vial of filler, is going to make a huge difference, you may well be disappointed. I'd love to hear what you think. We're open to educating ourselves here and everyone's opinion. Join us over on Instagram. We talk about these issues over there. Subscribe to the channel. Join our family here. And stay tuned to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.